My name is Dr. Matt Kudak. I'm an emergency department pediatrician here at the university and also a medical devices fellow here as well. Each year, there's over 58,000 gallons of opioids being prescribed to patients following just a few ENT surgeries, including tonsillectomy, abscess drainage, and U-triple P. That's enough volume to fill up almost two of these tanks. In addition, there's an ongoing opioid crisis here in the United States, and more people are dying or becoming addicted to opioids today and each year than ever before. 100 people are dying each day from opioids. For people who aren't becoming chronic abusers of these medications, they come with many side effects, and you can see a few of them listed here. In addition, there's no great way to deliver a medication to the back of the throat to apply pain relief for patients in following these procedures. So our solution, SmartFree, enables patients to apply rapid and targeted pain relief to the affected areas of the mouth and the throat following these procedures. In doing so, we have the ability to limit the amount of medication that a patient is receiving, thereby limiting the amount of side effects systemically that they're at risk for, and limiting the amount of complications that they're at risk for while still providing the exact same pain relief. Our reimbursement model is that a 7-day pack of the device will be sold to the hospital or surgery center, which will be sent home with the patient. In doing so, the hospital will realize cost savings following these things as you see above, including lower bounce back rates, lower narcotic use, and increased procedure volume. We will be quantifying the exact dollar amount that this saves going forward. In addition, the device will be billed to the hospital or to the surgery center by being incorporated into the current billing codes. And so again, this is SmartFree. We're here to spray the pain away.
So, do you have any IP protection on this?
Yes, we have a pen filed, and the main methods or the main things that we've protected are the device being a self-enclosed chamber that's bite activated, and then the method or the area in which the medication is delivered.
What's your regulatory path?
So it'll be a drug device combo. It'll primarily go through the Center for Drug because the drug has a main effect. The drugs that we're planning to study, which ultimately of the three, one of them will be the one we use, are all currently approved drugs. The two of the three are off label for this use currently, so we'll be working through the 505B2 pathway, which is taking the master file from a drug and then using it for a different indication or a different dose to get it through. So a much simpler pathway than a full new drug.
Does the device regulate itself in the sense that you don't want the patient to self-administer too much?
Right. So with each bite, sorry, I think we're feedbacking each other. With each bite, there will be a certain amount of medication that's delivered, right. And so it will be analogous to an albuterol inhaler. You bite once, or you puff once, and it delivers a certain dose of medication. And if you need a second, there will have a mechanism in it to prevent overdose.
What's your go-to-market strategy? Because obviously you need to get access to the drugs, and how are you going to be doing that?
So how the plan to go to market? So the initial plan, the first part of what we intend to do is to do a quick feasibility study to demonstrate which drug is the most effective. Like I said, all of these drugs are on label, and they all are generic forms now. And so the plan would be to work with one of the generic companies to use this device as a way to leverage their market share within the field to make them more successful while we still sell devices.
Quick point of clarity. So this provides pain relief just in that localized, within the mouth.
Right. So within the tissue, there's various receptors that will respond to the different medications that we'll be using. And so depending, no matter which of the three drugs that I'm exploring, that we choose, the receptors are there and it'll provide relief there without having to go through